economic alarms are flaring. The Fed is trying to stop inflation.
To those who point to the Fed and say you ran it too hot, you say what?
With the benefit of hindsight, I wish we had tightened sooner.
Higher interest rates will bring down inflation. They will also bring some pain to households.
We're now heading into what will be a new economic era.
It really is difficult to overstate how important this story is and how much it matters.
Chase Bank's trouble signal a wake-up call. Is your money safe? Discover why it's time to reevaluate your banking choices. The mighty financial institution, once considered untouchable, is now facing some serious challenges. Today, we are greeted with shocking headlines about Chase Bank's dire situation. From financial aid fraud cases to massive customer withdrawals, it seems like the once unshakable banking giant is now facing a storm of troubles. Is this just another instance of media hype, or are there genuine reasons for concern? In recent times, an alarming trend has emerged, a run on Chase Bank. Customers have been rushing to withdraw their funds, resulting in an astonishing $200 billion worth of deposits being pulled out. This significant loss in deposits is a clear indication that people are growing increasingly concerned about the stability of the banking system. But what could be fueling this fear? Is it merely a knee-jerk reaction to sensational news? Or are there genuine reasons for the escalating unease? The decline in customer confidence comes amid the release of a Gallup poll, which echoes a survey from the 2008 financial crisis. Almost half of Americans now express concerns about their funds, raising questions about the security of their savings and investments. As the bank run continues, it becomes apparent that something deeper is at play, and it's essential for all of us to understand the implications of this growing mistrust. To truly comprehend the gravity of Chase Bank's predicament, we must look into their financial performance and stock market data. In their latest earnings presentation, it's revealed that the bank's total assets amount to a staggering $2.3 trillion, compared to $2.5 trillion in the past. This decline in assets raises concerns about the bank's overall health and stability. Moreover, as we look at the stock market, it's evident that the news headlines and financial woes have had a significant impact on Chase Bank's stock value. The stock has been experiencing fluctuations, with some periods of growth followed by sharp declines. Investors are growing wary, and the uncertainty surrounding the bank's future adds to the volatility in the stock market. Beyond the numbers and charts, it's crucial to assess the underlying issues and potential consequences that these financial indicators might have on the broader banking system and the economy as a whole. Here's the harsh truth. When we entrust our money to banks, we often assume that our funds are safely stored away for us. However, the truth is that the concept of deposits is more of an illusion than a tangible reality. Once we deposit our money, banks utilize it for various purposes without our explicit knowledge or consent. These funds are not sitting idle in a vault, but rather, banks employ them for lending, investments, and purchasing mortgage-backed securities. In essence, our deposits become part of the complex financial system, and the majority of the money we deposit is no longer physically accessible. This system raises serious questions about the actual security of our funds and whether banks can handle a sudden surge of withdrawal requests. As we witness the current run on Chase Bank, it becomes evident that we need to be more conscious of how the banking system operates and explore alternative ways to safeguard our hard-earned money. The echoes of the 2008 financial crisis reverberate in our current predicament, reminding us of the fragility of the financial sector. Back then, many believed certain banks were too big to fail, only to witness their collapse and the devastating impact on the global economy. Fast forward to today, and we find ourselves confronted with similar concerns and uncertainties. This historical context serves as a wake-up call, urging us to be cautious and vigilant in our financial decisions. While the circumstances might be different, the underlying issues of unchecked risk-taking and interconnectedness remain. The question is, do the banks always win? There's a prevailing notion that massive banks like Chase always come out on top, regardless of the situation. This perception is fueled by the belief that they have undue influence and control over the financial system, even extending to the corridors of power. While it is true that banks play a pivotal role in the economy and have significant leverage, the idea that they always win is an oversimplification. The reality is more complex, as banks also face risks and challenges. However, there's no denying that the banking sector's relationship with the Federal Reserve and their shareholders can create a powerful advantage. This dynamic raises concerns about fair competition and accountability. Amidst these concerns, another alarming factor comes into play: the real estate bubble. Commercial properties, particularly office spaces, are experiencing soaring values while remaining largely vacant. This raises red flags about the sustainability of the real estate market. As remote work becomes more prevalent, the demand for traditional office spaces is waning, potentially leading to a market crash. With banks heavily invested in commercial real estate, this bubble poses significant risks to their stability. As consumers, it's crucial to pay attention to this aspect of the crisis, as it could have far-reaching implications for the economy. The bursting of the real estate bubble may exacerbate the banking system's vulnerabilities, making it even more vital to reassess our financial strategies and seek alternative avenues to safeguard our assets. As the economy faces turbulence, credit card debt has also reached alarming levels. Many individuals are turning to credit cards to cover their expenses, creating a dangerous spiral of debt. While it might provide a temporary boost to consumer spending, the consequences could be dire. High credit card debt puts immense strain on households, leading to financial insecurity and reduced spending power. Moreover, rising interest rates could exacerbate the problem, making it even more challenging for consumers to manage their debt. This credit card debt crisis isn't just a personal issue, it also has wider implications for the overall economy. As we witness the effects of this crisis, it becomes increasingly important for individuals and policymakers alike to address the root causes and find sustainable solutions for economic stability. The signs are evident. Chase Bank and the entire banking system are facing unprecedented challenges. The media might try to distract us with sensational headlines, but it's crucial to see through the smoke and mirrors. Instead of panicking, let's use this knowledge as a catalyst for change. Take a closer look at your financial choices, diversify your assets, and consider alternative ways to secure your future. If you found this information valuable, don't forget to share and hit the like button. We'll be back soon with more eye-opening insights, so make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching.